I recently had a request for a parrot. So today I'm going to be folding a parrot design for origami. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to be folding my paper in half, and I have it as a diamond shape. So I'm going to bring the left side to the right side, line up my edges, and then carefully pinch my fold. Now I'm going to open this up, and I'm going to do what I call the kite fold. I'm going to bring the left edge to the center fold. So I'm going to roll this up and line up that left edge along there, and I'm going to be careful of the tip. I always like to make sure I've got a nice tip before I make my fold. I'm going to do the same thing with my right side. Roll it up so that this right edge is meeting the center fold. I line it down. I'm going to make sure I have a nice tip, and then I'm going to press that down. Now you can see why I call this the kite fold. Now I'm going to open this back up, and I'm going to bring my bottom, rotate it till it's at the top. And I'm going to do that same fold, the same kite fold. I'm going to bring the left edge to the center. Watch to make sure I have a nice tip at the bottom. And I'm going to bring the right edge to the center fold so that, again, my paper looks like a kite. Watch my tip there, looking good. And then I'm going to open this back up. Now these are going to be guide folds. So this next step is tricky. I'm going to turn this so it's pointing towards my body. I'm sitting right here. So I'm looking at this as a diamond. So this is pointing towards me. I'm going to be folding this in half right here. It's kind of tricky. So I'm just going to make that line a little darker so you can see it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring the bottom, this bottom triangle, I'm going to bring this up, and I'm kind of bringing these sides in. And I want to try and keep this even, slowly bringing my fingers together. And now I have this little loop popping up here. And you can kind of see my line right there. And I want to make sure I fold it so that ends up, that line hits right at the tip there, so it's not uneven. So I'm going to pinch that. See what's happening? And I want to make it nice and sharp at the bottom. So I'm going to hold this down, pinching this and creasing it. I'm going to go like that with my finger, make that a crease. Oh, I messed up my nice tip here. So now it looks like this. See how I flattened it down, and this part's sticking up like a shark fin. Now I have to do the same thing with the other side. So I'm going to set this down, rotate it. I'm taking these two funny triangles here and bringing them in. It's sticking up. And then I kind of inch my fingers in towards the bottom here. So I have this funny little loop sticking up. And then I'm going to put that down to the side of the way. I'm going to kind of pinch this. My finger like that to make a crease. Take my finger like that to make a crease, and I have another shark fin. Okay, so now you have this form. Again, it's very symmetrical, it's very balanced. I'm going to set it down, and I'm going to push these triangles flat. And crease them back this way. I'm going to point them towards me now, because what I'm going to do next is I'm going to take this triangle right here and here, and I'm going to fold them in half this way. So I'm splitting this angle. So I'm going to do this side. I'm going to bring this edge right here to that horizontal line and crease it. Then I can just unfold it and do this one so it's not in the way. So I'm bringing this edge to that horizontal line, and I'm going to fold it and crease it. Now these will kind of just overlap over each other. These are actually going to become the feet of our parrot. So we're looking at this right here. Now I'm going to turn it so I've got more of a long diamond, and I'm going to fold it in half so those little triangles are going to stick out. Careful as I fold my tip so that stays at the nice point. There we go. See those ends like that. Okay, so right now my feet are sticking up, and I'm going to take this top one only, there's two here, and I'm going to roll this edge up to this line here. So I'm splitting this triangle in half, so I'm rolling it up. Give that a nice crease. This is going to become the tail. And I have to do that on the other side too. So here I've just folded that flap. I'm going to turn it over. I want to make sure I'm doing it on the same side. Like this, you know, this is the tail. So I switch this to the left. Now I have to do it on the left here. Roll the bottom up. Crease it down. And now this is the tail and the feet. So we need to turn this into the head. So we're going to make the head here, and we're going to kind of curl this around and see this. We want it to curl around. So what happens is I'm going to make a fold down like this. And that kind of makes like a head and a beak. Could stop there, but I want to make it look more like a parrot. So I folded it down, but what I'm going to do here, this is called a reverse fold. Push this up like this. I have that fold. Opening up the bottom. So I'm pulling it, and I'm going to, see how it popped? And this is going to pop down. Squash that. There's the start of the head. Now I'm going to do the same thing again for the beak. This is what makes it look like a parrot, that little hook. So again, I'm going to go like this and open it up. This time I'm going to push that fold in and squash it. And there's my parrot. And you can actually balance this on a shelf. Parrot will sit on the shelf, which is kind of fun. And if you want, you can go ahead and add details if you have crayons or markers.